Students of English Literature, today our topic is third part in this lecture, third English version lecture from the chapter The Judgment Seat of Vikramaditya, that is written by Sister Nivedita and it is from supplementary reader. Students, in lecture 2 you came to know that one of the cowherds boys sat on the mound and began to pronounce right decisions and give justice to all the persons who put their difficult cases before him. Now let's see what happened next in this lecture 3. Now the king, who lived far away from Ujjain, heard this story and he thought that the boy must have definitely sat on the judgment seat of Vikramaditya. The guess of the king was correct. Actually, these ruins where the boy used to sit, and now which are the meadows, were once Vikramaditya's palace. And there was dust, and now there was grass and trees, and then they turned into pasture, and the cowherd boys were using as their grassland. If just sitting on the mound brings wisdom and justice to the cowherd boys, the king thought, why can't I be the judge? In this way, the goddess of learning and justice would come to me. I will hear the cases and the spirit of Vikramaditya will come upon me, will descend upon me as well, and I will be known as the judge of justice, and I shall give perfect judgment. So with the spirits and showers, the grozy knoll, the mound where the boys used to sit was overturned. The boy, who had been the self-made judge, was sorrowful. He felt that something dear of him was being taken away. At last the laborers came on something. They uncovered it and found a slab black marble supported on the hands of the wings of 25 stone angels. Surely it was the judgment seat of Vikramaditya. With great rejoicing, it was brought to the city and placed in the hall of justice. The king ordered his people to observe 3 days prayer, fasting, and announced that on the fourth day he would ascend the throne publicly. He was preparing himself to sit and he was thinking that he would be a perfect judge now. At last the great morning came and crowds assembled to see the king and take seat. Walking through the long hall came the judges and priests of kingdom, followed by the king. Then as they reached the seat of judgment, they parted into two rows. The king walked up in the middle, bowed his head in reverence and went straight to marble slab. Students, but there was something different. When the king was about to sit on the throne, one of the angels began to speak. One of the angels, 25 angels who were supporting the black marble, who were like the base of the marble, came out and asked, stop. He said, would you, and asked the king, do you think that you are worthy to sit on the judgment seat of Vikramaditya? Have you never desired to rule over the kingdom that were not your own? For a while the king could not think of an answer. He was answerless. He was puzzled, but he knew that his life was unjust. After a long silence, he spoke, no, I am not worthy. I am unworthy. At this, the angel instructed the king to go then and fast for 3 more days, and then you would come, so that you may purify yourself and be worthy to sit on the throne. With these words, the angel spread his wings and flew away. And now there were only 24 angels, because one of those angels flew away into the sky. Students, there is one most important question from this passage. What did the first angel say to the king? Then this underlined portion, you can quote all this, and you can also write this answer in indirect form. The angel asked the king if he thought that he was worthy to sit on the judgment seat. It means you will have to change this do you think direct form into indirect. And after changing the person and after changing the tense, it will be your answer. Students, in this way, all the green portion in this passage will be your answers. And students, you continue to watch lecture number 4, RSE classes of English language. Please like, subscribe, and comment. Students, if you have any problem, you can ask in your comment box, and I hope you will like it. Students, subscribe our channel, RSE classes of English language, and keep on watching English literature and grammar as well. Thanks.